Okay, so I was going to post a video that I made about an hour ago, and it's a Sunday morning. I'm at my favorite sacred space near me, Etowah Mounds, and there was some people weed eating the mounds. And I always get frustrated when I come up here on the weekends and they're doing that work because I'm like, it's the weekend, can we get a break? And I used to get really, really mad, frustrated, angry about it. And as I continue to work on myself and understand that, number one, I'm part of a society where we have created all these things that we need to do. We need to mow the lawn. We need to weed eat. We need to this, that, and the other. I understand that the reason that they do that on the mounds is to keep them to where we can come and visit. But after sitting here for another hour and journaling and doing the things I do to continue to peel back the layers of myself, I finally came to realize, and this is a spiral, right? These are cycles that come back and come around. And the cycle that keeps coming around is control. We are all and have been programmed and conditioned to think that we can control everything that is around us. We cannot. I can't control when they decide to weed eat the mounds. I can't control when I, think, all right, well, I'm going to send an email to them and tell them about it and get upset about it. And what's that going to do? It's going to get them irritated. They're probably going to tell me there's nothing they can do. This is the only time they can do it, or whatever the reason. But I can't control what they do. The good news is, I can control seeing all sides of the situation, being the observer versus being in it, and understanding that it is what it is. And as a lot of my friends say, and two in particular, it's for the highest good. And it is, because it is a lesson for me to not control all that's around me and to control just me. This weekend has been another wonderful, enlightening one for myself. Seeing me go through all of these changes is a blessing. I interacted with some people at my Unity Church, the drum circle I did on Friday. Then I went and had this beautiful dance with the soul dance community in Mo's, and did a cacao ceremony with over 300 people. I think it was 400 people. And what I'm understanding with cacao is that it's a heart opener. And my intention was to go to this dance and continue to open my heart. I always thought I have an open heart. I love people. I love things. I love this planet. But just until the past 10 years, am I really understanding what love is? And all of our hearts are so, I can't think of the word right now, but just so covered up with all of the things, the controlling things, especially the conditioning of what's around us, the societal things, the materialism, all these things we hold on to in our heart. As I'm learning in my Qigong studies, it's the emperor. It's the emperor of everything in our body. So when I went and danced last night and had my intention that I just wanted to open my heart, and I came here today and I went down my normal road of why are they doing this? Why are they weed eating? Why? Control, control, control. And then I sat and I thought. And I thought intentionally. I didn't think with my emotional mind. I thought with my heart mind. My wisdom mind. My intuition. And it said, listen, how long are you going to continue to get upset and try to control things that aren't in your control? Why not use that energy to release it, to share what you're learning with others? So the more that I get here and come here, every month I have a special place that I come to, and I hope that you find a special place that you can go to and continue to do the inner the inner journey. A lot of people are saying inner work, and that is what it is. It is work. We have to come and sit and do these things. But it's such a beautiful journey in really getting to know ourselves, our true selves. And I know that's part of us getting older too. We become older, we become wiser because we get through these cycles over and over again and we learn. And every time it comes around, we learn something new. And all these things we've heard many times before. So I'm just sharing what I'm learning. And I was going to post the video earlier that I made, and then I just deleted it and made this one instead. So I hope that this helps you understand yourself a little more and to know that we all are here to love, to open our hearts. And I'm still basking in the beautiful energy that I was with 400 people that basically wanted the same thing. So there is hope. We can find ourselves again. And we can find each other. And when we come to each other, we come with love. Thanks for listening, for watching. And I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. And I'm always sending peace, love, and soul.